The goal. What is it? A goal? What isn't a goal?
Okay, very good point. If the disc stops short like that, that is a dead disc, and it automatically goes right to the defense. Offense cannot rebound off the goal. They also can't slam dunk from here. You have to catch off the water on offense, and you have to score off the water. So if you come up here, the goal's wide open, and if the referee sees you come up and let the goal here, you cross the plane of the goal, and that's goal taking, and however, that's an offensive foul, and you have to score. The disc has to come off the water to score. Now, if the disc, that one's close, Mark. If the disc is not down flat, it's not a goal. So that would be arguable, because it's actually in the plane, it's stuck on the side, that almost rarely happens. Just fell down by itself, so that's a goal. But if the disc is up like that, that's not a goal, and defense can take it right away and go the other way. If it is a goal, it'll get scored as a goal, but defense can still take it right away and go. Just like a basketball, you take the ball, take the disc and go right away. Okay, so if the disc lands up here or on the top, once in a while the disc will knock the flag down and we'll just stop the game and put it back on. So anywhere on the goal is a dead disc, often a defense takes it and they become offensive go the other way. Defense can guard anywhere around the perimeter, but if a disc is coming in, defense can't cross the plane to deflect a pass in here. You've got to deflect from the outside. So if you're in here, you're goaltending, okay? And obviously, if you're in here knocking it out, that's goaltending too. Let's see, what else? Okay, if you want to move with the disc and squib, just like in basketball or soccer, you dribble with the disc, and you can call it dribbling, but we call it swimming with the disc. The game's called squib, but we call it squib because you swim and you skim or skip the disc. So to squib with the disc, you can either otter, and it'll stay in your eddy and just follow you around, okay? Or you can, if you don't want to go backwards, you can go forwards. As long as you're alternating hands with the disc, you can move with the disc just like this and alternate hands. And there's no, in basketball there's traveling if you stop and start. In swim there's not, you can't stop and start. You can pick the disc up, throw to pass, you can put it back down in the water and move on again. But the game is always much faster if you're doing a lot of passing. Anything else?
How do the bumpers work? If it goes out of bounds?
Great. Okay, you can see there's a color code here. Around the goal area, it's red. Those are your scoring zones, or what we call our red zones. And then the white area is a neutral zone. That's a transition zone. So we have some, who has played soccer again? You're familiar with offsides in soccer? Offsides in swim means offense can't go behind the last defender. And if that defender might be the goalie, or if the last defender is back on the back wall, offense can go anywhere they want. But if all of the defense moves up, they can move all the way up to this color break, and offense can't go behind them until the disc, with the offense controlling it, breaks the plane of that color break. Okay? So if the whole defense comes up and challenges you, you could probably just score over the top of them. Or you can throw the disc in the back and sprint to it, but they can force you to stay onside. Okay. Also, there's three ways to score and 3 points.